surprisingly, in this day and age, there's still a hell of a lot of places that are inaccessible. Even the annoying thing of having one step means I'm not able to get in there.
This is like magic. This is a dream come true. I've always thought of technologies like this as someone with a disability.
One big thing is to show myself that, you know, any lingering doubts that I have, that disability can be a barrier. I expel them.
I want people with a disability to use my robots and make their lives better and to feel more independent. My name is Marita Cheng. I'm a mechatronics engineer and I've created a telepresence robot. You know, people use the term teleporting very frequently. You know, in sci-fi, I guess you've got Star Trek where people can just beam in somewhere.
You're a genius.
We've decided to call our telepresence robot Teleport because we think that it gives people this immersive experience of being somewhere else. You can literally be in two places at one time. So I was born in Cairns in Far North Queensland. My parents got divorced when I was 1 month old. So my mum looked after my older brother and I as a single mother. And we lived in housing commission and she worked as a kitchen hand and then as a hotel room cleaner to fund my brother and my education. When I was 11, I was thinking, what do I want to do when I'm older? And I thought I want to be part of the robotics revolution. And now the revolution is taking place and here I am. Put some other wheels on it so that you can like tilt it forward. So I studied mechatronics engineering and computer science. And in the first year at university, I counted probably 6 to 8 other girls in a lecture theatre with like 200 people. And I thought, I could actually make a difference to the number of girls in my class. And RoboGals was born.
RoboGals aims to get more girls interested in engineering and technology careers. How we do that is by visiting schools to run robotics workshops.
We've now done that with over 60,000 girls all over the world in 10 countries. We teach 12,000 girls a year.
Young Australian of the Year for 2012 is Marita Cheng.
You know, it was just mind-boggling to be recognised at that scale. I had a lot of job offers that year, but you know, I didn't even think about any of them. I just wanted to build robots and I wanted to start my own company, so that's what I did.
Well, we can just raise it by using the battery and the linear actuator.
So I think the most exciting thing about robots is that you're making life easier for yourself in the physical world, and I think the perfect place to start is to help those who have some kind of physical disability.
I used to be the fastest runner in my primary school. I remember nothing used to stop me, so I used to climb over barbed wire fences, through tunnels, yeah, constantly on the move. My name's Anthony Bartle, I'm 36 years of age, and I had a car accident when I was 6 years of age.
A neighbour ran in and got me and said, a child has been hit by a car, and then finding it was my Anthony and feeling devastated. His spinal cord had actually been cut, which meant that he would be paralysed from the neck down for the rest of his life. That was enormously hard. After they gave us the diagnosis, we then had to make a decision about whether or not to continue care. So we went to him at the bedside and we explained to him the best we could, that if he wanted to go to heaven, that was okay. But if he wanted to stay with us, he needed to blink his eyes. So I remember he looked at me directly and blinked and blinked. And so that's what we did.
The hardest thing with my newfound disability would probably be my new way of thinking with my attitude. So I only think what I can do and what I can't.
Well, he's both independent and very dependent. You know, he has 24-hour care. In spite of that, he's done things that I haven't done. He's been on a microlight aircraft. He went on to millionaire hot seat.
You just won 50!
I just realised that life has so much to offer, and I feel that my disability shouldn't be a barrier to experiencing all that. But one little step, you know, a few centimetres high, really shuts me out.
You know, got all these steps behind me. So it does make me feel even more disabled.
Teleport means that someone with a physical disability is able to travel, explore a museum, explore places in another country. They could just go to school or go to work without all the hassle of needing to get ready and doing all the physical preparations to their body to get them from A to B. Hi, Anthony.
Hi.
We brought Teleport along for you. We reached out to Anthony because we thought he'd be the perfect candidate to use his technology because he's such a adventure-loving free spirit. Here we go.
Exciting.
We've actually managed to make Teleport brain-controlled. So you could put on a brain headset and all you have to do is concentrate and Teleport moves.
What am I doing, just thinking?
Yeah, just concentrate on like thinking about one thing.
Whether it goes backwards or forwards. Well, the house I live in at the moment, I've lived in for a lot of my life, but even though I have lived here for so long, but I've never been down to get upstairs. It's really plush looking, isn't it? Oh, they've got a nice looking couch here, haven't they? Using the teleport was pretty amazing. I'd never controlled anything with my brain, so that gave me a level of independence by itself.
I want people with a disability to use my robots and make their lives better and to feel more independent.
You know, some people say in time Anthony may walk with new technology, and I don't know if that will actually happen or not. But, you know, technology like the teleports are exciting, dynamic things.
I feel more free and it would make me realise that the world's not such an inaccessible place, and it would make me feel like I'm not excluded from as many things. Yeah, well, it's one less barrier to have to go through in life.